Oh yeah, hi guys, welcome back. Ken does gloves of teleportation. Where are those at?
Teleport a target character or item to a point of your choosing.
Is it like charge based?
Let me test this real quick.
Is it charge based or what?
Where are they? Let's find out. Right. Like, I was worried it might actually be like, oh, you need to have the skill for this, but no, I don't. I just know this. So let me say, like, hey, Sibyl, you want some high ground? Let me get some high ground, fam.
Where is she? Does she take damage or something?
Yeah, took a bit of damage for that, 10 damage, it's not too bad.
But you can also toss enemies into fire and stuff.
Yeah, so like, but like... Okay, other question.
Yeah, actually Sibyl is...
Can I put this on Beast and use it to teleport himself into combat? Oh no, if I keep it on me, I can teleport Beast into combat! It's a bad call.
Make him go the old-fashioned way. Oh hey, there's like fucking dismembered things here. Fucking, it's snack time, come over here.
Dinner.
All right, let's see here. Yeah, go ahead. Oh, a chunk of flesh. Eat that.
Looking around for joy, you feel excited.
Those gloves are legit so good for me, actually, because I usually have like some skill points left over.
We're listening to things. Overcome.
Who knows what could happen here?
It's literally nothing. That guy. All right, dismembered torso.
Early memories overshadowed by a terrifying death, a tempest of teeth, scales, and snarls. You never imagined it would end like this.
And head.
You are ever sodden, ever sandy. The smell of guts and sea waste cling to you like a ghost. You sought freedom, the life of a seaman, but you didn't find it.
The life of a seaman? I think consuming intestines isn't going to do anything for some reason.
Cute disease.
Yeah. Bloodstained journal. Alright, what's the bloodstained journal?
Yeah, the Skelebro up here.
They're finding a vault. Vault ought to be outside the prison. Or maps my golden ticket. Okay. Vault. There's a vault quest we have now. The Vault of Brachus Rex. Oh shit, yeah, that guy. Remember that guy.
Who? I don't know who that is. I've never played another game.
Oh, there's a skeleton loot. How did you not loot the skeleton?
I did loot the skeleton. He's got nothing on him.
Well, he is a skeleton.
What are you trying to say?
Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Alright, so is that it for here? I guess it was just a really complicated fight and that's it.
A really complicated fight where I got fucking gloves of teleport. Baby.
Yeah, that's pretty worth actually. Oh, there's a chest over here. I'll get that. Oh, it's locked.
Oh, nice. Okay. Well, I guess this is going to
take that for later. Sibyl, you can take that. You're not carrying anything. All right. We're pretty good.
Good adventure, everyone.
Good adventure. Yeah. We need to get some lockpicks from someone. I'm actually curious what's down here. All right, let me give it a save. Because, yes, you never know. Oh, there's a cooking pot, nice. And a simple rhyme.
A cooking station. Can I take that?
Oh, yeah, we can cook whatever we want now. How does an apple go? Apple doesn't do anything. Oh, a herring. Oh, dinner. Oh, dude, I could have made more dinners.
I remember this dinner. It's so familiar to me.
Another dinner. I love dinners.
I can make cold mashed potato.
What does the mashed potatoes do? Alright.
So I can make a whole dinner right now.
I'm gonna talk to this person.
She seems totally at peace, but as you approach, she turns to you with a cheerful smile.
I haven't seen you around here before. New?
See that? Say you are indeed new, and you failed. You've yet to find someone who will address a prince with the proper deference.
A prince, no less. Don't think I ever had the honor. Must be strange for you here among us poor folk. You here alone, Sir Prince?
Sarcastically declare they forgot to send your slaves along with you when you were exiled. The darn nuisance, that.
She gives you a long look.
You've got a sharp tongue. Seems to me I hear a whole lot of bitterness and anger at the root of it, though. A sharp tongue's a poor companion, you know, You think twice about facing this mean world alone, eh? Someone to drink to in the evenings, someone to hold at night. If you've got those, you'll be all right. Some of us haven't got anyone at all anymore.
Well, thank you for the
it's
advice.
It's nothing. If I haven't learnt that by now, I haven't learnt anything at all.
Why are you here alone?
Used to be, I had a family. A husband and a little boy. We were healers. Source was in our blood. Then they brought us here. I couldn't stop them from taking my boys from me when they did. Reckon they were cured. Maybe even released. Don't know why the Reds didn't take me too. Now I'm just waiting for them to call my name. Waiting and remembering.
Use that you had a whole family too. A whole house, in fact. They didn't stand by you. They exiled you.
Poor fella. Can't imagine such a thing myself. Family's not supposed to do that.
She looks out over the waves. For a while, the sound of them lapping on the beach is the only thing you hear.
Don't we make for a fine couple? Here I am, pining over my family. Here you are, pining over yours. In such different ways, too.
So they like to think of something else. A loving family, for instance. Why didn't she tell you about her boys?
Her eyes sparkle.
Kind of you to ask. Stefan. He was my little one. Smart as a whip and no less wicked. And my husband, he was called Felix. He was an expert healer. Could fix a broken bone in a short minute.
Wonder if she has anything that saw as interesting. Well, she had an identifying glass. And she has res scrolls. Holy shit, they're expensive.
Yeah, they are. Don't die.
Don't be fucking casual. Hey, you want a pepper?
Use some cooking, why not?
Or a potato. Give me a pepper. Yeah. I don't want to buy that. I'm fucking spending gold on that. Fuck that shit. Alright. Your family sounds lovely. Thank you for sharing.
Listen to me bubbling on like a cauldron. You're sweet to listen. And yes, they were lovely. Totally lovely. I'll see him again before I'm gone for good. That's for certain. You run along now, darling. You shouldn't spend what little time you've got left here listening to an old bleeding heart moan.
All right.
The cat's eyes are
clouded. The cats always say the same thing. I think the cats are in on this. I'm just going to tell you
no,
that
it's now. The same cat.
I don't. Is it just following us around?
It's following me.
Oh, why? What the fuck have you done? Whatever.
Here you are. I wonder what keeps you. Tell me your tale.
I have an unusual way of speaking.
Your tongue is not my tongue. Elves speak of here and now, not then and when. These words strike us strangely.
What do you mean?
We are unfamiliar, yet familiar. We are the same material, you agree? I am very curious. So tell me. Tell me your tale.
Ascent, why not?
Start from the beginning. Start from where you come.
Divulge that you hail from an ancient empire. You lived in its fabled forbidden city.
I see, I see. Now tell me more. Tell me what you do. Tell me what you find.
Tell him several things will come next. Answers power your throne.
I understand. Now tell me how your story ends.
See, that will end in death and victory. Whose death and whose victory remains yet to be decided.
You speak fiercely. You speak without fear. You are a warrior. A being of power. And ever in need of it. Power comes from strength, and strength comes from growth. These seeds sprout, so does the iron in your spine. I give my word.
Thanks.
It is nothing. Many fragments swirl on my shore. See what I gather.
Oh, he's a vendor. He's got, what the fuck? Random skill books. He's got nails. I think you can make nails into a lockpick, can't you?
I think, like a hammer, maybe.
But he's got actual lockpicks as well. Yeah, he's got a repair hammer, too. Okay, you're probably going to want to talk to this guy.
Yeah, I'll pick up, like, some stuff.
I'll go look over here. He's going to just give you, like, he wants you a fucking your life story, apparently.
Didn't want my life story.
There's a quest here, actually. I might go actually do this. So I'll start this off. Go see, it's Singtail. Let's just save it before it starts a fight.
Am I awake? I think I need a pinch or... No, hang on. It's you. They said you'd be red, but I didn't think so... so very red. Hmm.
Who are they?
They is them. Yes, those. There are many words for them, but I'm having trouble finding the right ones.
Come to your senses. You seek answers, not riddles.
My apologies, Prince. I'll be better momentarily. In two shakes of a lizard's tail. Yes. Being suddenly roused startled me. Swept between sleep and awakening, I could not be certain. Is it really him? The very one I've been waiting for? But it is you. All rugged and ragged. How the mighty have fallen.
Ignore Sneer remark and tell you've been having a strange dreams that you urged him you to find a dreamer.
Just so. How very reciprocal. You see mistress in the night, so do I. Oh, I'm just your man. The they I spoke of, O Majesty, are my dreams, the brain born of sleep. I see you in my wondrous foggy fantasies, sire. They speak to me. They say that you are the one that will bring about the change. But there are those that oppose the change. There are those that want you quite dead.
Demand he tells you who wants you dead.
I do not know.
Alright, what change?
I cannot say.
Okay. With all the patience you muster, ask him why he's being so bloody reluctant.
For you, your majesty. For your life, and for your destiny. See, this is the very X in the crux of the capital M'd matter, Prince. What we must speak of is very delicate. What we must speak of is very dangerous. What I must know, I do not know when I'm awake. What I must tell you out in the great sleep.
Hold on a moment, are you saying we must sleep together?
And an honor it will be, your highness.
Oh, good. Good. Get your fucking fanfics out.
All we need to do is close our eyes and let sleep take us by the hand. Then we shall meet in the great realm of dreams, where the whispers will reach me, and through me, their words will be yours.
Fine. Let's get it over with.
There's one little, let's call it, complication, though. Dear me, this is frightfully embarrassing for a dreamer to say, but... I find myself quite unable to dream. My sleep has become blind and silent. I want to aid you, of course, my lord. Indeed, I need to aid you. But I am in just as desperate a need of my medicine.
What's your medicine?
The leaf that enlightens. Trudene. Should I partake of the leaf, Prince? We will both know what it is the spirit of sleep wants us to tell you.
Alright, roll my eyes. I guess I'll go get him some.
Not quite. No. See? I have some, yes. But I stole it. They think it was an elf that did it. A Myro. They locked him in a cage. I'm torn, your highness. I should return the Drudene and set the elf free, but I really, really want to dream and see.
Yeah, fuck the elf. Tell him to take the one he has. Tell him to know what he sees and hears in his dreams.
Yes, of course. I cannot deny you, Prince, whatever my reservations. Let us partake.
Stingtail reaches into his pocket and fishes out an orange, telling you it is in pieces of fruit that he hid his contraband. He devours it greedily, and his eyes begin to glaze. A yawn, a few mumbled words, and the lizard falls asleep. You sit in the sand, close your eyes, and follow him. From shadow comes sunshine, your home. You're in your own palace, atop the great library tower. You behold the Forbidden City, only it's infinitely bigger than you remember. A sea of white marble that reaches as far as the eye can see. Stingtail is here too, but when he addresses you, another voice lurks behind the dreamers.
From shadow comes sunshine. Quite right, your majesty.
but not if the shadow gets its way. You have questions in here. I have answers.
Who is Shadow? Who wants you dead?
The Shadow itself. The House of Shadows.
All right, why?
Alas, even to one such as I, their reasons remain ensconced in darkness. No one knows the House of Shadows exists. Therein lies its victory. But we, the Dreamers, we know them. And we do not leave them to weave their black webs around our empire unperturbed. The mighty houses of war and law, they are the true shadows, unaware of the dark sun that rules their days. Now, the House of Shadows moves against you, but in the House of Dreams, you have an ally. We pledge allegiance to you, a one and only prince, a one and only king to be. We see the golden throne. We see you, the shimmering flame amid the gold.
All right, I suppose that in the metaphor, you're the sunlight, correct?
Of course you are. The spouse of the sun, the red prince, and so much more.
So you take it this is the change he's referring to?
Quite so. But let's not discuss the change just yet. Stingtail stung too soon. Right now we must ensure your safety. Should you perish, the change perishes with it.
All right, what should we do next?
You must escape from the island you are on, break through Fort Joy's walls, and venture into the Hollow Marshes. Another dreamer awaits there, Bahara. She is a far greater dreamer than this Stingtail. She can take you further through the realm of dreams. For much further, you must go. So wake now, Prince. Wake and be wary. Be wary of the shadows that would snuff out the sunshine.
You wake up, as does Stingtail. He yawns and stretches his arms.
Well, now, what a dream that was. What a palace we saw. Can't say I remember much else, though. Not a jot.
Ask him what he means. How can he not remember?
I saw you atop a tower. I reached out to address you. But after that, all went blank.
Say, you won't forget all the talk about the House of Shadows in a hurry.
Shh! Word, my lord, you mustn't say such things aloud. Not in this world. What if they hear? They could be anywhere. So was it really of them that the dream voices
spoke? Sasha, yes, the dreams that spoke of the House of Shadows.
Oh, by all that is holy, your highness is too courageous for my taste. Such bravado does not favor my constitution. But let me bid you a fond farewell, your majesty. Long may you live, and long may be your reign. If they'll let it.
Does he have to trade? Does he have pyrotechnics? Oh, dude, haste? That's a lot of money. So fuck that.
Dude, I knew you'd care for that.
Away from the lizard, Sibyl cups your chin.
There's a mock crate back here.
There are some.
Then guides your eyes to hers.
Wait, there's some characters your companions want to speak with you privately. Forbidding this may negatively affect your relationship. Okay. Sure.
Listen, I need to have a chat with this here morsel of flesh. He has wronged me once, but may just do right by me this time.
I see why not. Go ahead and have that chat.
To your surprise, Sibyl proceeds to throttle the unsuspecting lizard with one hand as she drives the tip of her needle into his lower belly with the other. Then the questions commence.
It's time for me to examine a companion, see their attitude towards me.
You hear him yelp about the master, lone wolves, and a man called Griff.
The fuck? Is that you? No, you're not. No. Griff.
Then, quite suddenly, there's blood everywhere as Stingtail falls to the ground, face first into his own intestines. Sibyl heaves a sigh of satisfaction, and as she wipes her needle clean, shoots you a cursory look.
Chat's over.
Yeah. Just a tad excessive. Oh good, we get boots. Oh dude, we get haste! We get haste for free!
Bad.
No, I think Sibyl likes me, it's fine. What's her... I'm gonna go talk to her, fuck it. What's like?
Something on your mind?
She murdered a dreamer, committed a sacrilege, demand explanation, grab her by the throat and sneer that you should do to her what she did to Stingtail. Oh, but I let her do it, though.
It's simple. He scarred me, so I scarred him. extensively.
She defies you with devilishly innocent eyes.
Can you blame me?
Admit that if someone had luckily scarred you, your reaction may have been the same.
There it is. I was wondering when your spying would make an appearance. Anyway, what's dead is done, so let's move on, shall we? Despite my high hopes, this scar disfigures me still.
Alright, what's next?
The search for the master continues, of course. Hungry work, the hunt. And you know what? I'm feeling a bit peckish. Stingtail mentioned a cook, as it happens. Fellow named Griff. Two birds, one stone. How about it?
I know where that guy is.
The sun shines bright.
I'm supposed to be able to see, if I examine them, like, what they're... opinion of me is. I guess his attitude. It's 20 right now. Kind of nice. All right, are you done looting this place?
As one crate hidden, not touching because it's mocked. It's spooky.
Oh, she doesn't have. What? Wait, does she not have pyrokinetic? I thought she did. Oh, I have to actually select her to let her have those abilities. All right. One second. I'm going to drop Peace of Mind, and I'm gonna put on Haste, because I like Haste better. Okay, so where's this marked crate?
Right here. It's spooky.
Alright. Well, that's what saves are for. The fuck? Oh, I moved it. I mean, it just says True Brew. It says fucking book. Herb called Whisperwood. A small magic armor potion.
It'll be useful.
Alright. Alright, I got like a pair of boots. Unusually large orange. That's the one that I can open it. Oh dude, what the fuck? I can put things in the orange. The orange has more space in my backpack.
Remember he's using it to store shit?
Yeah, I know. I just think it's funny. It's better than my backpack. All right, we also got some seeds from the other guy before. It's weird.
There's also this cave over here.
It's telling me how to make a cooking station. What cave? Oh. Wait, is there something else to do here with Stingtail? No. Why does it still show up as an objective marker for me?
Maybe you're drunk.
Yeah. Wonder what it's saying. Escape. I guess it just says that it's an objective.
Do you want to poke inside the cave?
Yeah, let's do that. I was guessing she was gonna kill him, and I guess I don't know if it's that important.
I've spotted something.
The fuck? Oh! No, I wanna
do it. No, I'll let you do it. I know you wanna do it.
I'm not opposed to manual labor if circumstances require.
Yeah, boy. Bloody's key.
Oh, the dog! Talk to the dog!
What dog? Oh, that dog. Oh.
Doggo.
I'm not fucking paying attention. No, get back here.
The old dog looks up at you, but doesn't lift his graying head from his paws. He heaves a heavy sigh.
Well, it's his name.
I'm Buddy.
Oh, he got his key, though. Ask the pooch what's the matter.
It's no use anyway.
Give the dog some fish.
The dog tentatively sniffs the offering, then grabs it between its teeth, and swallows it.
You're nice. Emmy would have loved you.
Ask whether this Emmy is the reason he seems so blue.
She was my mate for the last 7, carry the 2, plus 55 years. The Magisters, they took her.
Tommy's really bad at math. He's not alone for now, at least.
I love you.
Oh, that's adorable.
Say, let me show you something.
Alright.
Show us the key of your dog.
The dog focuses at the cat at your feet, baring its teeth and growling.
Yeah, the dog hates the cat. Alright, so we got a key now. What do we use that on, though?
A dragoon?
Yeah. His buddy's key. What's his key for, though? Oh, we can't actually go in here.
A little reprieve from the din outside.
Well, we have his key. I'm not sure what it's for, though, but we'll see. In a bit, I guess. What do you think the deal with this place is?
Well, there's a little area at the back there. We could... Looks dangerous back there.
Oh,
I think it's barricaded off.
Yeah, you're right. Let's check that out.
Save first, maybe?
Of course we save first.
I'm gonna look over here. Maybe there's a secret thing here. Okay. Oh, there is. Ah, shit, I'm sorry.
What'd you do?
I dug something up. I didn't mean to.
That's okay.
Oh, dude, an ancient stone hatch.
Ah, okay. Fuck, where do we go first? Fine, it's an ancient stone hatch. That seems more interesting.
Do you want to take the lead?
Time for adventure. Forgotten cell.
Like Dragon Ball Z?
Yeah.
I can't wait to spot traps.
That's a big guy.
For you.
Yeah, I know. Spear of Brachus Rex. Oh, it's the tome. But he's probably not fucking... I'm gonna take the spear, fuck you. I'm going for it. Yeah, I got it.
Good sir.
Oh.
You've set my body free.
Is it time?
Crumbled to dust at last. But my spirit... Blast! I remain trapped in this moldering skeleton yet.
There must be strong magic at play here.
I have heard of such magic, but have never known anyone so foul as to employ it. Brachus Rex. May maggots lace his entrails. After he interred me in this cell, he must have drawn my very soul away from me and stored it elsewhere in the fort. Thus, he has bound me entirely to the mundane realm. But I know this place well. I could lead you to its likely location. In turn, you would find a path straight out of this fort. My freedom for yours. What say you?
That sounds good.
Marvelous, my friend. Marvelous. You'll first have to get inside the fort itself. There's a secret switch on a statue of the Seven in the courtyard. Surely you know it. The switch will open a hatch, and you'll be led into the prison's main floor. I suspect that within Brachus's phylactery room, you will find the container which ensnares my soul. He has likely disguised it well, but search there for another hidden switch. Brachus would have made me a supplicant, a slave to these walls. With your help, I'll die. At last.
Ask
with dignity.
Ask him how he knows where his soul's kept.
I was fully briefed about this awful place before I came. My goal was to destroy the fiend who had been marshalling the world's most unwholesome weapons and magic into an army he intended to use against the realm. I never thought I would become one of his victims. And yet, here I am.
Can you tell me about this island?
Fort Joy is a dangerous place, my friend. Dangerous indeed. Brachus used this place to build an arsenal of terrible weaponry as yet unseen in our world. Here, he and his researchers crafted punishments and snares contrary to human dignity. Objects that could contain souls, ones that could purge the very essence from sorcerers. My order would never have used such barbaric magic against our enemies.
Alright, well, he's good. How's this? Oh, dude, this fucking staff is so... The fucking spear is so much better than what I had before. It's a spear of Brachus Rex, dude. And I can...
How good is it?
I can set slowed and petrified for one turn, and 10% chance to succeed when I hit something. Pretty good fucking...
Nice.
Pretty good fucking item. Alright, what was in the chest?
Some pants I gave him to the tank.
Yeah, you're right, this cat is following us around. I didn't even realize it, but you're right.
It's following Ethan around.
Yeah. Well, that was quite adventure worthy.
I mean, you got a nice item out of it, don't complain.
I'm not complaining, I got a spear. I like spears.
Spear of a Dune?
Yeah. Hoi hoi hoi. Fuck.
Well, this crate's reinforced. At least that one is.
Get the fuck out of here, fucking thing. Oh my god, every time. Alright. Barricade. See, I got petrified up.
Petrified wood. It's not like regular wood, but petrified.
Looks like they're trying to keep us out. There's a water barrel here. Alright, one sec. Man, how long is it going to take for us to get level up? Where's that experience bar?
Bottom of the screen.
Is it? Oh, yeah. Okay, so we're close.
75% for me.
Yeah, same here. Oh, reinforced crate.